collides around us. In our everyday life, we come across different collides. The clothes we wear, the food we eat, the newspaper we read, and the houses we live, all these involve collides. Let's see some general examples in our daily life which act as collides. In that, first one, blue color of sky. Blue color of sky. I said earlier that colloidal solutions have color properties. The color of colloidal solution depends on the wavelength of light used. The wavelength of light in turn depends on size, shape of colloidal particles. You know, in air, there are so many particles in colloidal range. Smoke, dust particles are in colloidal range. These colloidal range particles scatter the light. So that's why sky appears blue. So the blue color of a sky is due to Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect is nothing but, what is that? Scattering of light by colloidal particles. So the blue color of sky is due to scattering of visible light by colloidal particles. Okay? Right. So this color may change sometimes. Clouds, they show different colors. That is due to difference in the size of colloidal particles. Second one, formation of mist, fog, mist, fog, rain. Let's see about this. I already said that air contains dust particles and smoke particles. Smoke particles means carbon particles. When, because of some reasons, the temperature of air is decreased, that means air is cooled below its dew point. The temperature of air is decreased below its dew temperature, what happens? The moisture in air get condensed on the fine dust particles. Moisture in the air condenses on the fine dust particles. So then the size of that dust particle, because of aggregation of moisture, increases. These particles, being in colloidal range, they continue to float, because colloidal particles, they just float in air. So moisture particles, that means which small water droplets condensed on dust particles, being in colloidal range, they simply float in air. That air containing these particles is called their mist or fog. So mist or fog is due to the formation of colloidal ranged particles by the condensation of moisture in air on the dust particles. So that is fog or mist. Next, what is rain? So you know, clouds are nothing but colloidal solution. Fine droplets in air. Cloud is nothing but fine droplets in air. Because of some reasons, if temperature of air decreases, when the temperature of upper atmosphere decreases, then what happens? The droplets, water droplets in cloud, they come into contact, and their size increases. Because of increase in the size, they come down by gravity force as rain. So rain is due to aggregation of water droplets in cloud. It happens when the temperature of upper atmosphere decreases. So not only that, sometimes two oppositely charged colloids may meet. One positive cloud, another one negative cloud. When two oppositely charged clouds when meet, because of mutual coagulation also, the fine water droplets which are in colloidal range aggregate. Because of this aggregation, size of particle increases, so those particles which are more sized come down because of gravity force as rain. Okay, so this is second one. Third one, food materials. In our daily life, we use different food materials. Cheese, butter, halwa, jellies, juices. These are all nothing but colloidal solutions. Halwa, cheese, butter, jellies, fruit juices. These are all examples for colloidal solutions. Fourth one, blood. About blood, I have already discussed. What is dispersed phase in blood? Albuminoid substances, red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, some etc. These are all albuminoid substances. Those act as DP. Where dispersion medium is water containing some ions, that is blood. So blood is a colloidal solution, solid in liquid type, colloidal solution, and it is an aqueous salt. Now, when if some cut occurs, what happens? Bleeding takes place. To stop the bleeding, alum is used, alum or ferric chloride. You know, this alum or ferric chloride arrests the bleeding by clotting the blood. So there, what happened? Blood being colloidal solution, bleeding is arrested by coagulation of salts. Alum, ferric chloride, these are nothing but salts, electrolytes. When an electrolyte is added to colloidal solution, what happens? When an electrolyte is added to colloidal solution, what happens? Coagulation occurs. So this coagulation causes a clot. That clot prevents the further bleeding. So in that way, bleeding is stopped by the addition of salts. Fifth one, soils. Soils. You know, fertile soils are colloidal in nature. Fertile soils are colloidal in nature, in which there is a substance, humus, acts as protective colloid. Humus present in fertile soil acts as protective colloid. So because of that humus, colloidal solution may absorb moisture, or it may take up nourishing materials which can be supplied to the plants for their healthy growth. Okay, so in that way, soils are also colloidal solution. Next, one more example, sixth one, formation of deltas. Formation of deltas. What is this? Delta lands. What are delta lands? See, it is some river, it is flowing. Finally, it is meeting an ocean. It is ocean. It is river. Water which flows in river is a colloidal solution. River water, which contains some suspended particles, acts as a colloidal solution. Whereas sea is a source of salts. It means electrolytes. Sea is electrolytes. When the river water meets sea, what happens? The salts in sea causes coagulation of the particles present in river water. So as a result, by coagulation of salts in ocean, what happens? Coagulation of clay particles, because river water contains clay particles which are in colloidal range. Those clay particles get coagulated. Because of that coagulation, these are all deposited. The deposited all clay particles form a delta like land. What is that? Delta like land. So in that way, deltas are formed. So deltas are formed by the coagulation of clay particles in river water by the salts in sea. Have you understood? So these are some colloidal solution which we see in our daily life. Some colloidal solutions which we see in our daily life. Okay?